We're in Canton, Ohio, and our main event's coming up in a few moments. Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert versus Samu the Samoan. Well, let's show you what happened earlier tonight with Eddie Gilbert interviewing with Jim Cornette.
So what do you think that your chances are today against a guy like Samu?
Well, Mr. Cornette, only thing I'm asking, give me the chance, whoever it's against, I'll wrestle him, and I'll do 100% to beat him, and I'll try my best to come out the winner.
Eddie, maybe you ought to turn around a little bit, just like this. The director's telling me we need to get a little bit better shot of you. Just like that. Just there you go. Okay, so what you're saying that basically Samu... Get out right! Fruit cocktail! I love it! Health food! Come on, boy!
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the TV main event. It is set for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first from the island of Samoa, weighing 302 pounds, Samu!
Samu the Samoan making his way to the ring. Want to say hello to the fans in Boston. The NWA returns to the Walter Brown Arena at Boston University. On Friday night, May 4th, the tickets go on sale at the Walter Brown Arena box office and at all Boston area Ticketron locations this Monday. For that big event in Boston, tickets go on sale this Monday.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Lexington, Tennessee, weighing 224 pounds, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert!
Gilbert rolls into the ring, but Samu, the 302-pounder, gets right on top, and now Gilbert grabs a handful of hair. Now he rolls on top, and it's Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert with a succession of right hands, and now he's biting the big Samoan. Look at that. The guy can't even fight by the rules, but that's what I like about a guy like Eddie Gilbert. He gets his butt kicked. He comes out here and gets his butt kicked again. He don't quit. Oh, rights and lefts by Gilbert, snapping the head back of Samu. He looks like Joe Louis there throwing those right hands. Come on. He's got to have something in that fist. Gilbert giving away about 75 pounds to this big guy. Samu, 6'4", 302 pounds. It may be a physical mismatch in the eyes of some, but not as far as Eddie Gilbert and his Legion of Fans are concerned. Legion of Fans, probably the foreign Legion. I'm putting my money on Samu. Samu's big. He's bad. He's tough. And he already turned Eddie Gilbert into the Kool-Aid flavor of the month just a little while out here. That's the International Legion of Fans. Scoop slam by Samu. Vance. Oh, there he goes. He's tangled up in a rope. Holy mackerel. He's gonna be hung like that. This could be an execution right here. Gilbert taking advantage. Man, he must have the strongest neck in wrestling. Gilbert with a drop kick right off the apron, he goes. Samu, who started this all with... Will you tell me that you had nothing to do with that interview, him coming out?
I had something to do with the interview. I was holding the microphone, asking the important questions. Samu just took it upon himself. I swear I got a signal from the director, said turn Eddie around a little bit. We can't get the good shot of it. Wait, you ought to ask the director. Well, don't ask him right now. Ask him later on.
I will. You can count on it. Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert waiting on Samu. The return to the ring, Gilbert.
Gilbert's a mad son of a gun right now for what happened, but Samu, he's making him sweat. He got outside the ring and took a little time out.
Gilbert going downstairs, but Samu fights back. Oh, what a chop there. Well, we got some comments to make tonight, fans. Again, the Wrestling Hotline will be coming your way tonight, late night. We hope you'll call 1-900-909-9900. Some new late-breaking information tonight on the hotline. Kids, be sure your parents know you're calling. That's tonight on the hotline, 1-900-909-9900.
I'll agree with you, Jim. It seems like there's a news story breaking literally every hour around the NWA these days. Something new's popping up.
Big clothesline there by Samu. Now Gilbert is in trouble. Fans, don't forget that big event in Boston. We'll be at the Walter Brown Arena at Boston University on Friday night, May 4th. Tickets go on sale for that in Boston at the arena box office. This coming, tickets go on sale, I'm looking here, Monday. I got it right. There's a lot of information to get out here. It's live television. This Monday, 9 a.m.
And that includes all Ticketron outlets throughout the Boston area. And Gilbert now taken to the rail by Samu.
Look at that guy. Look at the guy in the front row. He's beating Eddie Gilbert in the face. Repeated right-handed jabs to the face of Eddie Gilbert. Eddie's down. Eddie's hurt. Outside interference. What? Oh, I'm sorry. I must have looked at it wrong. Guy looked like he had a pretty good right hand on him there, though.
So many big events coming up, including the Meadowlands Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey, Thursday night, April the 26th. Tickets still available for that big event. Of course, the NWA this Wednesday night in Springfield, the Shrine Mosque. Thursday night in Kansas City at Kemper Arena, and Friday night in Corpus Christi, Texas at the Memorial Coliseum, and then 1 week from tonight at 8 o'clock in Houston, Texas at the Sam Houston Coliseum. I want to say hello to Pete Burkholz down there, our good friend, longtime supporter, and a man that's had a lot to do with the success of wrestling in Houston, and we'll be at the Sam Houston Coliseum 1 week from tonight. That's at 8 o'clock.
April 14th, and I'm looking forward to the Midnight Express. They're going to be there in Houston, Texas, our old stomping grounds. Peter Burkholz, the Peter Lorre of professional wrestling. And also, of course, we want to see all the friends of Paul Bosch there. I'm sure Paul still has a lot of friends and fans. They're going to be coming out as sort of a tribute to Paul.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you something. Eddie Gilbert has got his hands full here.
Ooh!
Gilbert is hurt. And while we have this opportunity, let's take our last commercial break. We'll be right back after this very brief timeout.
Next, it's...
And we are back here, ladies and gentlemen, from Canton, Ohio. Jim Ross and Jim Cornette here on World Championship Wrestling. They're in the commercial break. Samu, the giant Samoan, went outside and really was nailing hot stuff Eddie Gilbert. Referee Mike Atkins had to separate Samu from Gilbert, and now Gilbert finally makes his way back into the ring.
At that one point during the break, I thought Eddie Gilbert might be on the verge of turning the tables, but Samu has stayed in control. And Eddie Gilbert now is hurting for certain. A chop right up to the top of the chest, maybe across the throat, but the referee was behind Eddie Gilbert, so he couldn't have seen it. Anything a referee don't see is legal.
Lateral press. Gilbert gets the shoulder up. Now he got a kick out of it. Samu going for the pin here. Fans were very excited about next week's broadcast. 3 big hours. You heard it right. 3 big hours. Sabat kick by Samu here next week on World Championship Wrestling. Sting will have a major announcement. Mike Atkins got 2.5. A lot of people are speculating that Sting may announce his retirement next week. If that is the case, we will have that announcement here next week on World Championship Wrestling during our 3-hour broadcast beginning at 6:05 Eastern Time.
I think it would make a lot of sense for Sting to do just exactly that. I think that that would be the best thing for everybody concerned, because the Horsemen, I'm sure, they don't want to have to beat the punk up again. They probably get tired of it. And I'm sure that Sting don't want to be hospitalized again, so he better just get out of professional wrestling. That leaves the only major threat to Ric Flair is Lex Luger. And Lex Luger's already said he wants to seal his own fate by getting in the ring with Ric Flair in a cage match. So there you have it. Flair and Sting, in the next few weeks, are both going to be taken care of.
I'm sure we'll have some major announcements on next Saturday night's program. Hot stuff Eddie Gilbert, with the support of the fans here, rises back to a vertical base as referee Mike Atkins looks on. Gilbert trying to power out, and Samu takes him back down. He may have used the hair. I could not see.
I don't think he used the hair.
You never do. You never do.
Oh, I never do. I'll tell you what I'll never do again. I'll never do your work for you.
You're the one who wanted to interview Jimmy Olsen.
I didn't want to interview Abdullah the Butcher and Norman the Lunatic from the, like, they can't say 5 words between the two of them.
If you could have your way, you'd interview Roman about 4 or 5 times in the hour.
Well, if there's anybody out there that would rather look at Abdullah the Butcher than look at Woman, then, brother, you need a brain transplant.
Well, that is a valid point. You're digressing, but it is a valid point.
Yeah, well, you've got a point there, but if you comb your hair right, nobody will notice.
Thank you.
I'm not interviewing those two weirdos ever again.
Eddie Gilbert, the busted lip there from Samu. Reverse chin lock, and Samu using that mass to lean on Gilbert, make Gilbert carry not only Gilbert's own weight, but Samu's as well.
I'll tell you what, Eddie Gilbert's lip might